Also we studied absolutely the same stepwise and conserved reaction pathways. So I want to show you schematic representation of the potential energy surface for the whole reaction, for the stepwise pathway. So numbers in the first row are for heteroatom silicon, for the second row for the heteroatom phosphorus, and third row for the sulfur. Numbers in parentheses are results obtained with water as a solvent. Okay, let's look at these numbers. So what? Yeah, if you look at these numbers, formation of the final product with water molecule coordinated, we can see that when we go for silicon, we have very highly exothermic reaction, both in gas phase and with solvent effects included. For phosphorus, we have exothermic reaction again, both in gas phase and in water. But for sulfur, its exothermicity is already significantly lower in the gas phase, and also quite low in water. Therefore, we can conclude that at some specific conditions, for the heteroatom sulfur, this reaction can go in the opposite direction. The nature of heteroatom was shown to slightly affect the reactivity of the polyoxymetallate with dioxygen. Still, it's for electron oxidation process, and the overall reaction was shown to proceed with moderate energy barriers and was found to be exothermic, as I said already. But again, these exothermicities are relatively smaller for heteroatom sulfur compared to silicon and for phosphorus. Therefore, reverse reaction is unlikely to occur for silicon and sulfur as heteroatoms, but could occur for silicon and phosphorus, but could occur for heteroatom sulfur under some specific conditions. Interesting to notice here that the lack of reactivity of the final compound, biradical compound, towards the water molecule leads to the formation of the stable tetraruthenium polyoxymetallates, as one which we considered before, which is consistent with experimental findings. Previously, formation of such dimer was shown by several studies listed in these publications for heteroatom as silicon. Okay, now what about cobalt-4? What about polyoxymetallate where cobalt is used instead of ruthenium? So this study was motivated by the following facts: that scales required for the green fuel production technologies to be able to compete with conventional sources of energies are immense. Therefore, use of precious metals in these green fuel production technologies would be prohibitive. Ruthenium is more abundant and less expensive than several other precious metals. But nonetheless, for large-scale applications, its use would be problematic. Therefore, development of and evaluation of polyoxymetallates which contain multiple earth-abundant metals results from these issues. The earlier studies where metal oxides were screened as water oxidation catalysts indicated that water oxidation catalysts with cobalt with several oxygens as ligands of this type, like ruthenium in polyoxymetallates, are some of the most active for water oxidation and O2 evolution. And therefore, several mono and multi cobalt containing polyoxymetallates were prepared characterized and evaluated for activity as water oxidation catalysts. In 2010, we reported the synthesis and characterization of this sandwich type polyoxymetallate with four cobalt centers. So it was it was shown to be stable in after formation and in catalytic conditions. So here is the structure of this polyoxymetallate with four cobalt centers making this kind of belt sandwiched by two polyoxymetallate units. Here are just computational details of our studies. So studies calculations were performed using the TurboMol software. Geometries of polyoxymetallate species were optimized with CI symmetry constraint using this RIPB triple zeta valence polarized level. And of course, solvent effects were taken into account using the COSMO model and water as a solvent. In computational studies, ground state electronic structure of this cobalt 4 polyoxymetallate was found to be high spin species with this multiplicity 13. Computational studies provided excellent agreement with previous experimental data and with our experimental data on the geometry of this compound. Analysis of frontier orbitals of this species indicated that HOMOs of this compound are close in energy. The calculated energy gap the calculated energy gap between HOMO and HOMO minus 3 is just 0.24 eV. And same picture was found to be true for LUMA orbitals. Although the calculated energy difference between LUMA and LUMA plus 3 was found to be 0.55 eV, almost twice larger than in this case, almost twice larger than for the HOMOs, but still pretty small. Calculated energy gap was found to be 1.22 eV, quite small energy gap too. Four HOMO orbitals are mostly cobalt core orbitals, as we can see from this picture. And there is almost no involvement of tank state orbitals. Again, as we can see in this picture, HOMOs have most dominating contributions from the cobalt core and atoms which bind these cobalts to the tungsten ligands. And same is true for the LUMA orbitals.